healthy new year, and I look forward to the time when we can all be here without these on and smile and laugh and enjoy it without the mask. But I'm going to tell you a quick thing about Beethoven. One of the things that I, as a musician, always like to do is to make sure that I am treating the music as though the audience is hearing it for the first time. Because even if it's a piece that's one of these so-called war horses, right? It's been out there for a really long time, for centuries. It's been performed for all those centuries. And, you know, even if everybody in the audience knows it, I want people to hear it with a set of fresh ears. Because a composition is a living thing. It's not the notes on the page. It's the sounds. It's the ideas that we put together on how to make these sounds for our audience. And there's always a danger anytime you treat a piece as though it's some kind of like static work up on a wall. Because even when you go to a museum and you look at one of those static works on the wall, you shouldn't look at it as a museum piece that's stuck in time, but it's something we should always look at it with fresh eyes and treat it as though it's, you know, the paint is still wet on the canvas. And I always like to treat Beethoven especially like the ink is still wet on the page, because it is an entirely startling composition, this first symphony, in so many ways. He takes a conventional orchestra and he uses conventional forms that he learned from Haydn, that he learned from Mozart. He doesn't ask them to do technically anything out of the ordinary that you would find in a symphony that had been written 10 years before or 20 years before, and yet he treats the orchestra in an entirely different new way for the audience. He's a maverick who wants to shock you into paying attention. And with those opening chords, rather than having these great big grand C major chords or great big grand Cs, he kind of spends time with those opening chords, and he grabs his listeners, his audience, by the ears, and he says, "You're going to listen to me." And that is an incredibly bold, brave thing for a composer to do before he's even 30. This piece is remarkable in so many ways, and from the opening chords of the first movement to the way he speeds up the tempo in the third movement to the point where he actually calls it a scherzo, a joke, a humorous piece, to the way he starts the last movement not on a C but on a G, on the wrong note again, and he has this bizarre introduction in the first violin that takes off into this really joyous, fun piece, and then again, right before you get to the coda of the entire symphony, where he has these grand stops. And again, not on the chords you expect, right? He takes your ear on this magical journey, and he constantly keeps you on your toes and paying attention. And I hope you enjoy